So let me ask you this.
Discover the world of conspiracy theories.
I'm Tom.
And I'm Johnny.
And we are here to get you.
To start questioning everything.
So strap in, make sure you like and follow us on Facebook to get all the notifications about the show. I hope you enjoy. Hey guys, welcome to episode 21 of Let Me Ask You This. So, as you guys can see, Johnny is with me, like always. But behind us, if you notice something different, it has nothing to do with the episode. I just want you to know that 9/11 was an inside job. So, with that being said, today we are talking about Bigfoot. I, for one, actually do believe in this conspiracy theory because evolution, I think, has made it possible. Apparently, I found out Johnny does not believe in Bigfoot.
I don't believe that.
So, Johnny, let's start with one reason why you don't think Bigfoot is real.
I don't think they have enough proof to actually do anything for proving him, because a lot of people that believe in him, they think he's already been proven. We can agree on that, right? Because they kind of flip out on it.
Yeah.
But neither of that, no. I just think it might have been a publicity stunt.
For what?
For a journalist. I originally know one of the biggest things that got Bigfoot started was a journalist who thought it'd make a good Sunday read, which honestly does make a pretty good Sunday read, from two loggers that found a footprint. I'm not sure if you read that anywhere.
Yeah. So, but like, my main thing is Bigfoot is pretty much just like us, but a
bigger. Oh.
Yeah, just bigger, right? So
bigger and hairier.
So, before we get, like, too deep into it, people get Bigfoot confused with, like, the Yeti or the Abominable Snowman.
The Abominable Snowman? I thought that was just a Yeti.
Apparently they're different, so
is one more snowy than the other?
I don't... well, kind of. So, this is... and Sasquatch is different, too. So
wait, he's different? I thought Bigfoot and Sasquatch would be the same damn thing, because they're always searching for them. They say Bigfoot is just a Sasquatch, and Bigfoot's a nickname. That's what I read.
So Sasquatch isn't so much as hairy as Bigfoot, it sounds like. He's kind of more just like a wild person, like out in the woods.
Also, some of the kids we went to school with.
Yeah, so like anybody can be a Sasquatch, I guess. Case closed. Sasquatch are real. So
that's my career in the future.
Yeah,
around the woods, half naked,
long beard, just covering everything.
Shit, I can't grow a beard.
Oh. So Bigfoot, he's a hairy beast, or a hairy man, tall, 7.5 to 8 feet tall, has a big foot, and that's why his name is.
Bigfoot.
Yeah,
that's pretty good right there.
Yeah.
Really original, whoever came up with that. Thank you.
So, and then the Yeti is apparently completely different. So I don't want to get back in. So
why, is there any specific reasons why you specifically believe Bigfoot's out there?
Evidence? The FBI investigated him?
Oh, well, the FBI investigates so much useless stuff. Come on, man. They're the FBI. They're like the kings of wasting American taxpaying dollars.
But I don't know, I just think, like, the Earth is so big that something like this could still be living out there that we don't know about.
Well, you want to know something? They actually have, like, my apologies, I can't remember the name. But it's almost like an advanced drone type thing, and this has been going on for years. But it flies over the forest and actually scans all living things.
Oh, no, I know. But
so, my thing here, the fuck haven't they found Bigfoot yet?
Come on. Could be living in caves. Like, if something doesn't
want to be found... 24/7?
If something doesn't want to be found, it's going to hide. Like, how long we didn't know about giant squids, like, were actually real? Like, we thought they were fake.
But here's the thing. How much of our ocean have we not discovered? A big-ass portion. I'm pretty sure most of North America has been fucking discovered already.
Well, all because it's discovered doesn't mean, like, they migrate. Just people before migrate. Like, guess what? Up north, Like, right now, I bet you there's not a lot of Bigfoot up north because it's cold. You know where they're going to be? Down south.
You want
to
know what I can say?
And guess what? I'm looking at this map of, like, Bigfoot sightings and a bunch of them in Florida. And I bet you that's during the winter.
You want to know something? It just means more people in Florida did shrooms that time of year.
Probably. I mean, it's Florida, but, okay, it's also over in, like, Seattle. But we saw what happened with Seattle not too long ago. So,
what, Bigfoot is hanging out in Seattle?
Yeah, if you look at the map.
They're actually, supposedly, there's a military base in Washington that actually, they say there's, like, a massive amount of Bigfoot sightings around it for some apparent reason. They don't know why, just there's a lot of Bigfoot sightings around there.
Well, that's just like saying there's a lot of UFO sightings around Air Force bases.
I'm not sure if you heard the theory, but this is also another reason why I don't believe in fucking Bigfoot. But some people actually came up with saying Bigfoot, the reason why they can't find him is because he's actually an alien. He goes back up into the fucking saucer and flies away.
Never heard that. That's cool.
That's fucking dumb.
That's cool. So, I guess it's not really lizard people that we should be afraid of. It's the Bigfoot people.
No. Bigfoot's a slave to the lizard people. That's what it is.
You think that's what it is? So, yeah. You're admitting Bigfoot's real?
No, this is me just making fun of you.
Oh. Bigfoot's real.
You also want to know another reason why I think Bigfoot's not real?
Why?
All right, so you got this guy that comes up with this thing with a story, but neither that Bigfoot, no, they say theories go back many, many, many years ago.
Mm-hmm.
No, to even people drawing up caves. But neither that, the main conspiracy thing has been going on for over 60 years now. Officially started back in the 50s, I believe. But people are, at least what I think, is that, no, Bigfoot sells. They make a lot of money off this guy.
Harry and the Hendersons? Dude, they have so much
money based off all these different things that they can make based off Bigfoot.
Yeah.
All the publicity, and anybody can do it.
And you can just buy, silhouettes of Bigfoot, like just this shadow, and it's of him, like, walking, and it's funny.
Yeah, no, they actually, I saw somewhere, I shit you not, it's like a little plastic container type thing. Mm-hmm. You hang up on a little rack, and it supposedly says it's Bigfoot hair.
Bigfoot hair?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, here's another thing. Speaking of hair, some of the DNA tests that came back, of the so-called people that found Bigfoot hair, came back, you know what they were? Bear hair.
Bear hair?
Yeah.
You know, people do confuse Bigfoot with a bear.
Quite.
Or a bear with Bigfoot, I should say.
Yeah, no, well, basically, no, people also forget that big-ass bears can stand on their hind legs, and I say no, and they can't walk on hind legs. I'm not sure if you know that.
Yeah, up north, they have, like, a bear show, and
just walking around like people.
Yeah.
They're like, I'm human, release me.
I forget what town it's in, but yeah, they do, like, a bear show.
Yeah, there's a lot of things,
It's close to Storyland, I know that.
Trying to change the subject because you know him, right?
No, it's just on my mind. Oh, yeah, well, Oklahoma.
Okay.
I don't know if you guys heard about this.
Oklahoma.
Oklahoma is trying to pass a law to get Bigfoot hunting licenses. So, pretty much from, like, how I understood it, it was you can't hunt Bigfoot if you got these Bigfoot hunting licenses. And, you know, I trust the government. Why would they lie to us and say that Bigfoot's not real?
I heard a theory on this, though.
Yeah?
Okay. This comes from the guy that doesn't believe in Bigfoot. But supposedly the Bigfoot authorities, experts, enthusiasts, say the reason why the government does not want to release the existence of Bigfoot is because it will mess up logging companies.
Logging company.
No, because technically Bigfoot, no, speaking, he would probably put on the endangered species list.
Oh, and yeah.
No, I forget the name of it, but there was a specific owl that was somewhere, but it basically put an entire successful logging company under within like a night because, no, they discovered these owls are there, so they're like, yeah, no, you guys can't be doing this, so they basically went bankrupt in a night.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it's crazy.
That could be it, man.
But
see, this is why we should move to hemp. To save Bigfoot.
You see? This is what drugs do to you.
Save Bigfoot, use hemp. That's what I'm learning from this conversation. So, Johnny, you have convinced me more that Bigfoot is real. And that...
Dude, he's a fucking publicity money stunt. Dude, there's no actual solid proof of this guy.
I mean, there's also not proof of him because, like we have...
Okay, well...
We have, like, fossils of a Bigfoot. Like...
Oh, really? You have fossils?
Yeah. It's on the History Channel.
Oh, yeah, on the History Channel. Yeah, because they've not lied in the past.
I mean... Those who control history, you know, so we control history.
That was a very intellectual statement.
No, I totally forgot the actual quote, yeah, and it kind of bothers me that I forgot the quote.
That's what happens when you talk to a guy that believes in Bigfoot.
I forget quotes because I'm too worried about Bigfoot.
Well, Tom, I want to let you know, if I find out Bigfoot exists, I'm going to shoot him and bury the body before you again.
So nobody can know.
No one's going
to
know.
But if you find one, that means it has to be more.
Well, that means I'll have to become an actual Bigfoot hunter and kill them all. Man. I'll dress up but in his fur.
So sometimes, like, I like the whole thing of Bigfoot because, like you said, it's a big, like, money thing.
Oh, dude, they make
Bigfoot,
millions.
Or finding Bigfoot, the TV shows... They were so funny, and it was just like
dumbest shit ever.
It was just like big redneck guys running around.
You
want to
know what's funny? If they do prove that Bigfoot never existed, like scientifically, if they can actually prove it and finally get most people to die out, you damn well know these goofballs are still going to be making these TV shows for them.
Oh yeah, forever.
Is that show still actually on?
I don't know.
Yeah, you want to know another thing about Bigfoot? No, none of these guys have ever encountered them.
Nope.
Obviously, because they can't find shit in the woods because they don't know what the hell they're doing. But how the hell do they always know how Bigfoot, like, communicates? Because they're always, like, running through the woods going, whoo!
Yeah.
Woo! It's like, dude, I'm like, what the fuck are you doing?
You sound like an owl.
And it's like, wow, they just found a night owl. Oh,
so, finding Bigfoot is not on anymore.
Oh, it's a bummer. They get, like, 20 seasons out of it, and then they decided it was not good enough anymore.
12 seasons.
They made 12 seasons of that garbage.
Yeah.
12 seasons of sucking up people's fucking money.
Yeah.
Over a dumbass TV show about finding Bigfoot and they don't find anything. I remember watching that quite a few times and I was like, these guys are jackasses.
Yeah, it was always just... It was always on after wrestling practice when I was in elementary school. And, like, I would need to eat dinner and go to bed. And... That's what we just watched real quick. It was just a stupid TV show. And it was just funny. I found it entertaining because I was like, yo, look at these guys running through the woods just hooing at nothing.
Well, I saw another method they did, and that's another reason why I just don't believe them, is they had like a metal pot for cooking, and they started hitting a tree with it. And they're like, we're going to hear somebody else. A Sasquatch, dude. And I'm just sitting there going, oh, yeah? And all of a sudden, like, we hear, like, ding, ding in the back. I was like, oh, shit, I didn't know fucking Sasquatch carry around metal pots.
Yeah.
I'm like, you guys are not convincing anybody.
Whoa, did you guys hear that?
Yeah, it's exactly what they do. No, it goes on a talkie. Ricky, were you the one that did that? No? We got that recording, right? It's like, dude, that was not proof. That was not proof of that.
Yeah.
It's like, and you're asking about the recording when you're actually being filmed at the moment that you're doing that by some professional.
Yeah.
The professional's probably sitting there going like, looking at his boss. These guys are fucking stupid. Yeah. What's wrong with us?
Why are we doing this? Oh, we're getting paid a lot of money? Okay.
Yeah, Bigfoot sells, man. Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right. Look at my shirt.
It's kind of like those, so like... A little off topic, but we always go off topic.
Yeah, well, we're talking shit about Bigfoot.
Yeah, so now, well, we're talking shit about a TV show, so we're going to talk shit about another TV show.
Okay.
And that's pretty much any haunting TV show, like looking for ghosts, like ghost hunting.
Oh, wow. Ghost Hunters was legit. You can definitely use thermal technology to detect a ghost who produces no body heat.
Yeah.
They're real experts, man.
Real experts.
I need to start my own ghost hunting show.
And those were the same thing. It'd just be like, oh, make a sound, like, talk. And then you'd hear, like, a whisper. And it's like, oh. Yeah.
Oh, did you hear that? So, yeah.
I'm in the wrong profession. I need to make a stupid TV show.
Yeah, I'll be hunting for Wendigos.
Wendigos?
Yeah, no, they exist. They're out there. Bigfoot exists. Why can't they?
That should be a TV show. Hunting fictional characters.
What, folklore?
Yeah.
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 Why not?
Well, no, another argument I heard about from... It was actually the guy from hitting the metal pan against mm-hmm. the fucking tree. You know, yeah, we're going to get yeah. Sasquatch communication. Yeah, well, they said the reason why they didn't find it was because a car drove by and scared him.
All those times.
All those times, yeah. I was like, but near that, this guy went into talking about cryptids. And he goes in and he goes, if you want to think about it, a lot of animals are cryptids. Then he goes, giant octopus, he said. I was like, all right, Mike, no, he might be on somewhere. And then he went on to saying, the gorilla, mm-hmm. the panda, they're all cryptids. I'm like, dude, we've known about those for, like, hundreds of years. Like, we know about these things exist. I'm like, dude, we have still not found the Bigfoot. It's probably been about 100 years. I'm like, dude, you guys, shut up, man. That was the worst. You were starting good, and then you ruined it because you don't even know what the hell you're talking about. He didn't look like a bright one. That's another issue. I notice a lot of these people that are talking about Bigfoot, no, they just seem a little bit off. Like, they weren't loved enough as a child. They always, trail off.
So, this was something I was supposed to have pulled up, but I didn't. So, there's a website, BFRO.net. And it's the Bigfoot Field Researchers Organization. And... You know, it has their Twitter feed on it, but so you can always be up to date. They have a podcast, too. Not giving them a shout-out, but they have a podcast.
What, they just talk about Bigfoot 24/7?
I don't know how much you can talk about Bigfoot. That's crazy.
That's like a crazy amount. Go back up to the map.
The map,
the map right here. Is that 2021 Bigfoot? Ooh, click on this. Is there anything... Massachusetts, Bigfoot's hanging out in Mass?
Yeah, Bigfoot. So, you can go on Bigfoot expeditions, it looks like, if you go to the BFRO.net.
See, the video right there just made me think of something, man. Why is every video of Bigfoot just look like shit?
Yeah, like, dude, it's 2021. Why don't we have a good video of Bigfoot?
Well, I think the original Hellboy movie, that guy said it best. Why is it always the pictures of Bigfoot, the Yeti, Hellboy... Why are they always out of focus?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no, I can shoot somebody that is moving around quite well, can't you? And it comes out. Instead, we get some guy in a gorilla costume walking around.
Yeah.
And this happens all the time, man. We went to a school with a kid we used to wear a gorilla costume every Halloween. And
who?
Gamey.
Oh, yeah, he would.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's all we need to do. If we put, like, we just got to find a big guy. Me and you, and just have him walk, and we can videotape it, and next thing you know, we're on here because we discovered Bigfoot.
The FBI will be in Manchester, New Hampshire, being all like, yeah. Where's Bigfoot? And it's like, huh, you're wasting taxpayers' money, let's do this.
I would have been like, he escaped already. He missed us from like 12 hours ago.
Nope, no, I'd lead him on that goose chase. It's my money, you know, they work for me.
Yeah, Bigfoot's down there. Down, yeah, right down right there, yeah.
Yeah, if you don't find him, come back.
Yeah.
And we'll look up that way.
Yeah. I don't know, man.
You know, he might have took a left or a right. I don't really know. He asked for a piece of cheese.
Yeah, you gotta ask me, what other reasons do you have to believe in Bigfoot?
Like, yo, they have merchandise.
Yeah, of course they do. It's Bigfoot.
And the logo makes a foot. You guys need to check this site out.
Dude, it's Bigfoot, man.
They have hats, beanies, yeah. $28? Ugh.
Bigfoot sells.
Yeah, Bigfoot sells. That's true.
Yeah, Bigfoot sells, man.
Man, but I don't know. I think it could be possible. I mean, I've seen some really hairy people in my days.
I don't think Bigfoot's out there. Come on, man, give me some solid evidence that he's out there.
There's really not, like, so I don't think that, like,
yeah, exactly. There's no solid evidence because the guy doesn't exist.
Everything just, like, is just looks so prefabricated, and it's just so bad.
Every single video has something on it. You usually, then you, like, see him peeking out like this.
Yeah.
Like, and then it's like, dude, I can obviously, that's a guy in a monkey costume, like, the last 100 videos. You know, it's funny, whenever you hear about these people, like, this one time, I had a Bigfoot encounter, and then a couple weeks later, I had the same encounter. And it's like, what? And then, like, what are the details? What were you doing?
I remember the
Were you drinking?
The first one I saw on, like, the Bigfoot show, this girl was telling the story about how Bigfoot came up to her door and asked for a glass, or asked for a cup of sugar.
I remember hearing that, but I think it was a glass of water instead.
You think it was water? It might have been water.
It was a real. How old were you when this happened, when you watched it?
Dude, I was in, like, elementary school.
Yeah, dude, it was a long time
ago.
Yeah,
it was a long time ago.
I forget what show it was.
I think it was Finding Bigfoot.
Yeah, man, the show was on for a long 12 seasons, goddamn. But yeah, no, I remember that too. You want to know something? I bet you know our parents like, yeah, you don't want to tell them you saw a fucking Bigfoot. We're going to always lock you in the closet and give you bread and water for a week.
Yeah, but in reality, it was some guy buying meth for my parents. But anyways, that's what they do out there.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Alrighty then.
Yep.
No, I just don't think there's enough proof for these people to be running around. I don't know,
but there's been, like, so many sightings.
Yeah, you want to know something? These are people seeking attention.
This many?
And also, top of that, this map, entire map, this is a great example of the drug abuse in America. Because you motherfuckers need to lay off the damn crack and stop looking for Bigfoot out in the middle of the woods when you see a bear. That's Bigfoot. And footprints can be faked. I don't care what people say. It's because you see a big-ass footprint. No, it doesn't mean
anything. So, it looks like most of them are up in, like, the Vancouver area.
Yeah, no, that's... Well, the original sighting that got them got Bigfoot big was in California.
Yeah?
Yeah, that famous video?
Oh, the one where they were like, no, this is fake?
Well, the original video is what I'm talking about. The one that we just saw down there, that was shot in upstate California.
But also up in, like, Wisconsin... In Michigan.
Yeah, well, he's also spotted in Canada, too.
Yeah, I can somehow zoom out on the map.
You see? Yep,
yeah.
Canada.
Oh, it spins. That's weird.
Ooh. Yeah, but see, now he's spotted up in Canada and everything, too.
There we go. Yeah, not so much in Alaska, surprisingly.
You know why? Kodiak bear mauled him. No, you want to know why? It's because up in Alaska, they're a little bit more level-headed because when they're out in the woods... No, they gotta know it. So, and on top of that, they shoot everything out there. So
that's true. No, so Bigfoot probably knows not to go there.
Yeah, and on top of that, no, he would have been dead if he existed.
Not so much in Maine. It actually looks like there's been about 20 to 40 sightings.
You know why? Because he doesn't mess with maniacs.
Oh, this was last updated 3 years ago. Just so you guys know. But well, I don't know. There's just been so many sightings. It's hard just to be like. Something that's like so many people have seen.
Here's the thing. What's level ahead of me? Right, let's take the Predator franchise.
Okay.
Okay, let's say that never existed. Like, never existed, no, but neither that. I take the camouflage, like, no, you kind of see like that.
The night vision?
No, not the night vision, like how he cloaks.
Oh, okay, yeah.
I have been like so exhausted at times that I shit you not. I thought I saw something like that before. So I could make, say we just get rid of that. No, the franchise never existed. Predator never came, no one ever came up with those little comics and nothing like that. But near that, I come up with this thing, like, no, he cloaks and does all this new alien species. I guarantee you, I fucking guarantee you, there'd be hundreds of people throughout the country that go, dude, I think I saw what he was talking about. You damn well know him, right? There's going to be, and the first people that are going to be the best ones at once, because the first, like, five people that say, oh, well, I saw this, and they're in different parts of the country.
Yeah.
They're going to be the biggest ones that people go flocking to to get that attention. They're up there like, oh. No, and that's how they make their money. And that's
Nowadays, people don't really flock to people. Well, people just post stupid shit on the internet.
They post something on, you got YouTube, you got Twitter.
That's what I do. I just post this stuff to the internet because I... Attention. But nobody watches it, so I just...
I don't know, man. This is about Bigfoot. There's a lot of Bigfoot enthusiasts out there. And you want to know something? You should, if this video goes, like, anywhere...
To the moon.
To people that believe in Bigfoot, you'll be appreciated because they're going to be saying some shit about me in the comments. Bigfoot don't exist.
But he might.
No, he doesn't.
But he might.
There's no solid proof. I did hear, like, they found, like, a finger bone and a tooth and everything, and they said this might prove that, no, Bigfoot might exist. All it proved that something existed in the past and human evolution that probably didn't make it.
So that's another thing. So what if it's just like another type of species, like another?
Well,
I don't want to say species because it's human. It's just a different like generation that didn't evolve.
Well, okay, enough. Okay. Well, here's my thing about that. Neanderthals.
Yeah.
They're gone, right?
Yeah.
All other prior, other than primates and everything overseas that are obviously a different species.
Mm-hmm.
They're still there, but the rest of the human ancestors directly are gone.
But that's what I mean.
But no, let me finish.
Maybe these are the weirdos that had sex with the other animals, and that's what this is.
I don't want to fucking think about it, because that is a theory.
There you go. Makes sense. Horses.
You monkey fuckers gotta stop it. But, but near that,
to clarify, that wasn't anything racist. He was talking about monkeys.
What the?
Clarifying. PC, Johnny. PC. We're on YouTube. We gotta be careful.
What?
Gotta be careful.
Oh, yeah, to bring race into it. I wasn't doing that. But
Some people might not have thought of that.
But near that, basically. God damn, you got me all fucking thrown off, you son of a bitch. You did that on purpose, because you know I was on a roll. But near that, no. If these are some type of piece of, like, human evolution evolving, I'm pretty sure if they were that much of a failure, they would have died off.
But that's see, what if they're not that much of a failure? But also, I'm saying, like, what if it's people that didn't evolve enough to become us? Like, it's the evolution.
Yeah, but that's the thing. Evolution eventually would have wiped them out.
But yes and no.
Because nature has a tendency of doing that. She's kind of cruel.
But, like, lizards are dinosaurs.
Actually, birds are closer really related to dinosaurs.
Okay, so even birds. Like, birds have been around forever. Yeah, but,
dude, you know which evolution? The closest thing to an actual living dinosaur now would have to be an alligator and a crocodile, and they're lucky they actually survived, and they had to shrink down. You ever seen an original crocodile from the prehistoric age? Dude, you would shit yourself.
Oh, yeah, how big they were?
Yeah, dude, they're massive, dude. Yeah. T-Rex would be, like, sort of going down the water, and the crocodile would walk, ah! Take them out.
Yeah, no, they're huge. But that's what I mean. Maybe... And/or maybe it is the next step in human evolution because the Earth is pretty much failing because let's go back to PC and global warming. That could be a theory. Evolving to go back to the nature.
Are you saying...
Hey, everybody is becoming minimalist now.
Whoa. You just say humans devolved to become Bigfoot?
Yes.
Okay, so if it's global warming, why would we have more hair?
Why? Because an ice age is coming. That's what's happening. Because everything, all the ice melt.
The issue with this is that, no, we're talking about, this started in the 1950s, basically, the big boom, especially in the 1970s. I read about that earlier.
But near that, dude,
that wasn't as much of a big deal back then. So, no, I just don't think that's the thing in case. And damn you for connecting global warming to fucking Bigfoot.
Hey, man, you never know. You son of a bitch. See, this is what conspiracy theorists do. They just, it makes sense. It could.
At least let's go back to the alien thing. What do you think Bigfoot being an alien, what do you think the fucking likability of that is? That's a little bit fucking absurd.
I mean, so I, for one, do believe that there could be life out there.
There's no
way that we are the only things.
I'm not talking about that. Fuck, we talked about lizard people before.
Well, yeah. Hear that. But I don't actually, I mean, kind of believe in lizard people. That's not the point of this episode.
There's a lot of proof on the lizard people, dude. You know that.
But anyways, damn it, you throw me off. Alien and Bigfoot. So, I don't see why it couldn't be Bigfoot.
The reason why I'm bringing this up is because I heard about one sighting. And keep in mind, the person was telling this, it wasn't the person that spotted it. This is a little bit weird, right?
Yeah.
So it was the person that they talked to, and I'm not sure what she said. She said she was a doctor or something, I think. And that kind of disturbed me. I was like, what, you a fucking shrink? I was like, you shouldn't be believing this story. But neither that, she said, like, they saw, like, something fly through the woods and all, like, the trees moved. But near that,
that was a great description. Johnny, you should be booked for kids at the library.
But near that, then she said that they saw, like, a Sasquatch, like, right under there. And then, like, the beam of light, you know, the classic, and like, light with the little green people. Except the green people didn't come out this time.
No?
It was picking up a big hairy man and
flying him up there.
But near that, I'm just saying that going, like, really? I'm like, that's your proof of the saying that fucking Bigfoot's an alien. That's not proof. That's a theory.
So my question is, why do aliens always have to beam people up? Beam me up, Scotty. Like,
I don't know, man.
That's so, like...
You want to know why? Because it looked cool in the 1950s. Like, man, the fucking little Martian.
Yeah.
Flying by.
Well, like, the cows. Like, and destroy all humans.
Yeah, and you just throw them at people.
Yeah, and you just pick the cows up and you throw them off topic. But,
It was the dumbest thing I've heard about Bigfoot so far.
That sounds stupid. But, like, if they're like, yeah, we saw, like, the saucer land and, like, it opened up and, like, the Bigfoot walked in, that would be more believable. But, like, the fact that they were, like, we saw a Bigfoot get, like, sucked up through the air,
that, and on top of that, the person that actually told the story was not the person telling the story at that time.
Yeah, that's weird.
And it was like, okay, well, what happened to the other guy? it's funny, because it was, like, they said that the girl or woman or something, I believe it was a woman that actually said it,
mm-hmm.
but near that... What were they doing just walking through the woods? They didn't say they're hiking or anything like that. They're just walking, just chilling through the woods in the middle of the night.
Yeah.
What's the point of that?
See, that's what I never get, like, why... That was another strange thing. Like, why are you walking through the woods at the middle of the night?
I can understand maybe if you have notes that say, no, maybe you're camping? No, are you camping? No, you doing all that? You camping? But neither that, they're not doing that. No, they're just kind of walking around, and eventually, though, maybe they're depressed, maybe they're too drunk, which is usually what I think. I see some weird stuff when I'm drunk, because, I'm half... My mind isn't the same, and, these people need to acknowledge that.
So, I am listening, so this is my idea book for the podcast, right? For those of you watching. And I just had an idea, because we were talking about aliens for a second.
Oh, dude, they're out there.
Yeah. But, like, my question that I want to look into when we talk about aliens, because we're going to, why do people get beamed through roofs? Like, how does that happen? So, I wrote it down, so I didn't forget. So, as you were saying, Johnny.
But, no, I just don't understand these theories and all the people that are saying it, man. I'm sorry, there's a lot of stuff that doesn't line up with them.
I mean, it is weird that, recapping, it is weird that we don't really have, like, a good picture of Bigfoot.
Well, it's weird that we don't have a big, and on top of that, it's just weird that a lot of these stories just don't line up.
Like, yeah, it's
you kind of, like, even, like, see, on that fucking Finding Bigfoot, I was watching an episode earlier, and I watched him Finding Bigfoot down here in this thing because I just wanted to get like a little dose of what people are like to believe it. And there's one guy that I noticed throughout the entire thing that was a little bit more level headed, and I think he was probably just there for the money. But he was part of the team, and he was just sitting there going like looking at someone like it's almost like you could tell he's like, yeah, this person's full of shit.
Yeah.
But near that, no, he was like talking to these kids and everything. And he's like. So, wait, you kids just didn't run? No. Some giant hairy man started walking up towards you. And then you guys just sat there playing with your fucking soccer ball. And they're going, yeah. And he's like, you guys are some weird kids.
Yeah, you're weird.
And so, I was like, I like this guy. He had a cool voice, too. he should be a metal singer.
So, pretty much to recap, it's weird that we don't have a good picture of Bigfoot or a good video. Like, it's 2021. But... security videos are the same way, We can take pictures of Mars and Saturn, and have them come out in 4K. But, man, try to get a picture of Bigfoot or somebody that's robbing a convenience store, and you cannot. So, that's...
I got it. It's Bigfoot that's been robbing the convenience stores.
There we go. See?
Son of a bitch. Because he can't be caught on camera.
Yeah. It's a superpower. So... Maybe he is an alien. He has superpowers. And his superpower is to, just disrupt video, a photography. There we go. Bigfoot. Conspiracy theory.
Did you know any movies have been made about Bigfoot, too?
I bet you it's six.
Six?
Yeah.
No, I don't know. I heard that there's a movie actually about him being a sexual predator. It's a little bit disturbing. Probably an older film, too, I guarantee it. 47?
47 Bigfoot movies.
Slash films.
37 Bigfoot movie ideas.
That is insane.
Yeah, so there's at least 47 movies about Bigfoot. That's Harry and the Hendersons. That's like one of the most
famous
ones.
The sad looking Sasquatch.
Bigfoot Island. 1313, Bigfoot Island.
Ooh.
Official trailer.
That looks like a good
one. Oh, that was out in 2012.
We gotta watch that.
Nope.
Come on, man. Might have some proof.
Nope.
So you can prove to me that Bigfoot actually exists.
So it's not that. So I guess for me now, it's not that I believe that he's real. Or
convince
fake.
Them, guys. Convince
so, them. I don't think that he's fake either. Like, something like that could be out there. That's what I'm saying. Like, the El Chupacabra. I think that thing's real. Have you seen that?
No, I haven't really looked into it. No,
that's a good one.
I saw some funny jokes about it. No, it was on the Adventure Brothers. You ever watch that show?
No.
They were talking about chupacabras in the beginning of the thing.
Mm-hmm.
And then instead of going, oh, that was a myth. But neither that's part. No, it's not like the dog one, like the people say.
Yeah.
It actually looks like a little creature. But neither that, no. Part, no. It jumps out of the guy's his car when he opens it. And he goes, oh my God, what's that? And he takes out a knife and just stabs it in the head and throws it down. And he goes, the chupacabra is all from Mexico. Yeah, I'm just sitting there going, like, yeah, my, that was awesome. I can't believe I've never seen Venture Brothers, man. That's a great cartoon.
But, so, it's not that, like, I don't think that he's not real, but I also don't think he's real. It's weird. Like, it could be. I don't know. It's weird.
Oh, I know.
You know? You know 100% perfect.
He does not exist. We would have. I think
that should be your profession, is proving that Bigfoot is not real.
I'm not going to waste my life on a myth like some of these people.
But see,
unless somebody wants to start paying me lots of money.
So there was this person that I listened to for a little bit, and this might happen to you if you do this. So he went on a pilgrimage to prove that God was real. And on his pilgrimage, he lost his faith in God. So then he became an atheist. And then he started a podcast on YouTube. And he had people call in and try to, like, convince him that God's real. Johnny, that could happen to you. You could go on this quest and be like,
call in, tell me
that
Bigfoot's real.
And then, no, you'd have people call you to convince you he's not real.
Yeah, dude.
Because
if
you'd
I
be
could,
like,
if
real.
If people could want to do that, I would do that. And you want to know something? I feel like some of the stuff I'm going to say to him is going to hurt some feelings. And next thing you know, I'm going to end up in jail for, like, a hate crime or something. No, because I don't know who I'm talking to. Next thing you know, I'm getting yelled at by somebody. And then I have the podium and I have to apologize or something like that. Who knows?
Yeah, then they cancel you anyways after you apologize. And
it's like, what was the point of that?
Why did I apologize if you're just going to cancel me?
And after that, you know, somebody would just start another channel and start shit-talking again.
Yeah, I'm surprised that's not what a lot of people do.
Because they have the IP address a lot in lockdown. Damn NSA spying on people. You need to stop it.
Yeah. The Simpsons predicted it. That's another thing we're going to get into.
What, The Simpsons? They predict Bigfoot?
I bet you if I Google Simpsons and Bigfoot right now, something would come up.
I bet you they're going to... Maybe they'll... If they say they disprove Bigfoot, then you're in trouble. Bigfoot. Okay, Bigfoot Simpsons Wikipedia, yeah.
There's a Bigfoot in
Simpsons,
The Simpsons. Guys, it's proven.
Alive.
Yeah, status alive.
There's actually a theory on The Simpsons about the, like, predicting so much stuff.
That's what I want to talk about. A lot of it's actually fake. It's fake?
But some people just make memes about it, that's why. And they start these big rumors, that's basically what happens. You gonna get Bigfoot tattooed on your back? Like, Bigfoot exists. Johnny's wrong at the bottom.
Yeah, Johnny's wrong. There's just a giant black silhouette of Bigfoot. Just on my back. Just as big as I can get. And just below it, Johnny was wrong.
Would you hunt a Bigfoot?
I wouldn't pay to hunt a Bigfoot.
Oh, who says anything about paying? I'm going to cover it up anyway.
So, yes, I would hunt a Bigfoot.
Yeah, see, yeah. Honestly, it'd be hard to cover it up because that shit's going to look good on the wall.
Yeah. If Bigfoot was real, I would have to.
I would have to hide it as like a rug.
Yeah. But, like, but then, like, that comes down to, like, if... So, like, so let's say you go hunt Bigfoot and you, like, kill him and you bring him back. then you find out he's, like, a human. Does that go down as manslaughter?
Well, I'm covering up anyway. No big deal.
Well, no, I mean, like, these people in Oklahoma, like...
Oh, yeah, yeah, they talk about Heine. Well, that's Oklahoma being smart and making some fucking money. Good for you guys.
Yeah, but, like, let's say, like, somebody goes out there and they think that they see a Bigfoot and they shoot somebody.
That happens a lot in general, actually. No, you hear about Massachusetts. Oh, yeah, I'm talking shit, Mass. But, no, Massachusetts people, I've heard many stories about them coming up with their thing. And one guy shot, like, a dog. I forget what type of dog it was. And he thought it was a deer. And he believed he actually, like, put it in his truck because he thought it was a deer. I was like, this guy obviously did not pass a hunting safety.
That's crazy.
Another guy shot a cow.
There we go.
I was like, dude, what the hell were you hunting?
Aww. A cow. I got what I was looking for.
Hey, you just shot my cows. Dick. Yeah, Mass, yeah, but that's, yeah. I'm always going to be talking shit.
Well, so, see, Johnny did change my mind this episode. I don't believe in Bigfoot, but I don't not believe in Bigfoot. There could be something out there. You definitely changed the way that I thought about it.
And so, if you are a believer in Bigfoot, let us know, because I'd like to talk shit to you, too.
Yep. And, you know, it's Bigfoot. So, let us know if you believe in him. Let us know if you don't believe in him. And I don't think I can do a poll on YouTube. I don't know how to use YouTube, guys. I am not nerdy like that. I am different type of nerdy.
I don't have a YouTube channel yet.
Yeah. So, anyways, guys, thank you for tuning in to episode 21 of Let Me Ask You This. This was Bigfoot. Make sure you like, you subscribe, comment what you want to hear next. I would like to do something more serious next. We did something kind of fun this time. We talked about Bill Gates last time. If you guys didn't see that, go check it out. But yeah, I want to do something more serious next, and then we'll do something fun again. You know, keep it interesting. So guys, thank you for tuning in. Johnny, thank you for joining me.
Yeah, no problem.
It's been a pleasure as always. Later.
Bigfoot.
Bigfoot. Thank you guys for watching this episode of Let Me Ask You This. If you like this video, make sure you drop a like. Make sure you follow my Facebook and my Instagram, Let Me Ask You This, to get all the information about the show and new episodes. Thank you guys. See you guys next time.